You know, she was in The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills, and so you would pop in and out, and the whole kind of unraveling of that marriage
was laid bare, which I would imagine for you,
who's always run away from that kind of attention on your private life. This must have been like hell, wasn't
it? Well, I have to tell you, The Real Housewives was my parting gift to her. Now, whether or not it worked out well for her doesn't matter. It was my way of saying, look, you always wanted to be famous. Here you go. Everybody knows that reality shows are not particularly a great way to be famous. I mean, but you know what? You still get attention. You still get all those things that come along for the ride, which I think is what she was most interested in. And that was the gift. And I knew that when it came up, we'd be saying goodbye. I mean, I remember having one conversation where I said, well, don't worry about it. After the first season, you can do The Divorced Wives of Beverly Hills next season.
You weren't really joking.
No, I wasn't.
I mean, the strange thing is, at one stage, quite early on in the marriage, you said this. You said that Camille was the most profound, the most rewarding, the most honest relationship of your life, and that it was love at first sight for you. So I suppose the obvious question is, I mean, were you throughout that whole period, were you a bit of a spontaneous, incurable romantic? Were you just charging around looking for true love and constantly believing you quickly found it?
No, I think what I was trying to do was sell it to myself. You know, knowing that I didn't really have many more chances at something like that in my mind. Yeah. And I thought that this was the kind of relationship I should try to have. And it just, there was this still small voice in the back of my head saying, this isn't going to work. But I stuck to it.
How are things between you now? Because you've got two children. Mm. It's been, to put it mildly, messy. And you've pretty well kept your dignified counsel. But, I mean, how are things?
Well, not good.
Do you have any kind of dialogue with her?
We have no contact, no. There have been some very unfortunate incidents, public incidents, in front of the children. Stuff like that I'd like to avoid. There have been some attacks on Kate, which aren't, you know, particularly interesting, but I guess, you know, people say all kinds of things, but none of those are true, and we've had some difficult moments. The only thing that I've ever really wanted was to try to work out something that would be nice for the kids, but...
How is your relationship with them?
Oh, it's great.
You get plenty of access.
Well, they're doing their best to actually kind of make that difficult for me right now, and...
See, that's the part I hate.
So we're going to go to court a lot.
I hate all this. I'm very lucky. I have an ex-wife, and there's never been an issue with... I can see my children as often as I like. But when I hear other people who've been prohibited from seeing their children, I can't think of anything worse than that. To me, it would be like a dagger in my heart.
Right.
I don't know how any parent...
Well, she once said to me, she said, well, here's the thing, listen. Camille asked for a divorce... really almost the first day we were married. And it stayed that way for a long time. And I'd give a piece of advice to women who say, I want a divorce as some sort of tactic. Because if you say, I want a divorce enough times, you're going to get one.
Do you think she married you because you were Kelsey Grammer TV icon?
I think she married me because I was Frasier.
Really?